Humans have long been interested in the possibility of extraterrestrial life, life which originated beyond our planet. But how would humanity actually react if we discovered that life exists or existed somewhere else? How would such a discovery affect us?
Spraying us with flame. 2,000 feet.
In 1938, CBS Radio in the United States aired a dramatized version of the H.G. Wells novel The War of the Worlds, a story about Martians attacking Earth. Some people mistook it for a real radio report, leading to panic across the nation. However, accounts of the reactions vary, with some saying that not many people actually listened to the broadcast. Fast forward to today, humans have sent around 50 missions to Mars. About half of those have been successful. Most recently, as part of NASA's Mars Mission 2020, the Perseverance rover landed successfully on the Red Planet on February 18, 2021. The mission addresses high-priority science goals for Mars exploration, including questions about whether Mars was once home to life. Perseverance will seek signs that conditions on Mars were once habitable, and also will search for signs of ancient microbial life. The rover is equipped with a drill to collect core samples from the most promising rocks and soils. These samples will be set aside in a cache on the surface of Mars so that a future mission can recover them. Scientists could then study the samples in laboratories with equipment that is too large to take to Mars. But there's another way to study Martian rocks. Instead of going to get them, we can let them come to us. Intriguingly, scientists have discovered evidence of possible ancient extraterrestrial microbial life right here on Earth. In 1996, NASA scientists and their colleagues announced they might have found microbial fossils in a meteorite from Mars. The claim boosted public excitement and ignited a scientific controversy that continues to this day. President Bill Clinton even made a special address about the finding, and the X-Files riffed on it by depicting a lookalike of the meteorite with live bugs in it. The meteorite, dubbed Allen Hills 84001, was found by a team of American meteorite hunters in the Allen Hills area of Antarctica in 1984. Chemical analysis suggests that it originated on Mars when there was liquid water on the planet's surface around 4 billion years ago, making it the oldest meteorite that we have from Mars. Analyses with a variety of radiometric dating techniques suggest that a meteor impact on Mars catapulted the rock into space about 17 million years ago. It then traveled through the cold dark for millions of years before finally hitting Earth around 13,000 years ago. What a way to travel the planets. Scanning electron microscopy revealed structures that some scientists interpreted as fossils of bacteria-like life forms. Other scientists critiqued this view and showed that these formations could be created in the lab without biological inputs. Lines of evidence support each side of the debate, which is unresolved to this day. While microbial life may not have quite the allure of little green men or the nightmarish quality of Hollywood aliens, our chance of discovering extraterrestrial microbes seems better than that of encountering advanced alien civilizations. More and more scientists have begun to suspect that microbes may exist even now on moons in our solar system, perhaps in the subsurface oceans of Europa and Enceladus or the methane lakes of Titan. To understand how the public would respond to even such a relatively modest finding, a psychology professor at Arizona State University carried out a survey in 2018. Researchers started by running a variety of relevant space-related news stories through a program that analyzes language. They wanted to know if the stories had more words linked with positive emotions, happy, nice, and good, or negative ones, like worried, nervous, or annoyed. They also sampled essays describing how people would react to the news of the discovery of extraterrestrial microbial life. Finally, they looked at written responses or comments to a New York Times article about the Martian meteorite. In all of these cases, the words used were more positive than negative, the team says. But some argue that the study's results don't fully reflect reality. For one thing, study participants were located only in the United States, so these findings can't necessarily be extrapolated to other populations. There are also concerns about categorizing the words used in news stories as simply positive or negative, and using them to infer complex results. Additionally, there's a world of difference between accepting the presence of harmless microbes on a nearby planet and being confronted with a technologically advanced alien race. In more recent years, a wave of intriguing yet inconclusive reports of strangely behaving unidentified objects have emerged from reputable sources, including major newspapers, Ivy League professors, and military personnel. U.S. intelligence agencies are due to issue a press release about UAPs, or unidentified aerial phenomena. Some believe the acknowledgement of such events by governments and more reputable sources may foster public acceptance of the strong possibility of intelligent extraterrestrial life. What would this knowledge do to humanity? How would we react if we were presented with absolute, undeniable proof of extraterrestrial life, primitive or advanced? Some say there might be very positive reactions. Knowing that there is something else out there might bring humanity together. Others find cause for concern. Some prominent scientists remind us that advanced extraterrestrial beings may not be friendly and might even be dangerous. How would you feel if there was absolute and definitive evidence of life that is not from Earth? Answer in our poll below, and we will publish the results in our own study. Like, follow, subscribe, and catch us next time to see how you, plus science, can help save the world.